Hello, and welcome back to Entertainment Tech.
Stay tuned if you want to hear about the re-imaging of Dr. Dolittle in a new album from J. Cole. I'm Christina Cass.
And I'm Alea Burrell, and this is TV and Film.
Move aside, Eddie Murphy, there's a new doctor in town. Robert Downey Jr. is setting sail in the fantasy flick titled Dolittle, a re-imaging of the man who can talk to animals. The trailer for the upcoming film drops on October 13th, showcasing an entirely new idea behind the original 90s comedy about Dr. Dolittle, the veterinarian who can talk to felines, reptiles, and canines alike. The official trailer showcases John Dolittle, who resides in 19th century England with many of his exotic friends, but is called to search the sea with the help of these creatures to find a cure to an illness plaguing the Queen of England. Sprawling oceans with rich color and epic scenes decorate the screen throughout the trailer, creating the feel of an epic adventure. Big names can be found in the final seconds, such as Emma Thompson, Rami Malek, Octavia Spencer, and Tom Holland. We're excited to see the newest addition to the beloved tale of human and fuzzy friends coming together, so keep an eye out for the release date on January 17th.
The film Harriet, about the famed abolitionist Harriet Tubman, hit theaters on November 1st and is the first feature film that is solely about the American activist. The film documents Tubman's bravery in escaping from slavery herself and then risking her own life to help others escape. Harriet Tubman was born under the name Araminta Ross to parents Ben and Rick Ross on a farm in Maryland owned by slave master Anthony Thompson. Tubman was later moved to Bucktown, Maryland at 2 years old, where she learned outdoor survivor skills that eventually helped lead to her escape. In 1849, Tubman escaped to Philadelphia and spent the next 10 years traveling back to Maryland to bring other slaves to freedom on the Underground Railroad. Because of Harriet Tubman's courageous and selfless acts, she will forever be defined as a real-life superhero. I'm Alea Burrell.
And I'm Christina Cass. Up next, we'll hear Meredith speak on Demi Lovato's first interview in over a year.
Thanks, Christina. Demi Lovato gave her first major interview in over a year since her hospitalization due to an overdose. The 27-year-old pop star spoke to Teen Vogue Summit and opened up about how much she has learned from her experiences this past year. Demi confessed, "I'm so tired of feeling like I'm not human." The pop star and former Disney actress has had to learn how to deal with public criticisms after battling with addiction, eating disorders, and mental illness. Fortunately, a positive light is starting to shine on Demi's life. She is currently feeling stronger than ever, and she even stated that she is dying to release new music whenever the time is right. In other news, Full House actress Lori Loughlin has pleaded not guilty to the latest college admissions scandal charges. In October, Lori was faced with another charge known as federal programs bribery, which resulted in both Lori and her husband to plead not guilty. I'm Meredith Topian, and that's all we have for celebrity gossip.
I hope you enjoyed that celebrity gossip. I'm Ashley Brinkley.
And I'm Tayta Travis, and this is your fashion news.
Hi, Hokies, and welcome back. Everyone knows that Halloween just passed on October 31st, which per usual calls for Halloweekend from October 31st to November 3rd. Since it was Halloween and Halloweekend, costumes, and even more costumes are needed. A lot of Virginia Tech students got very creative this year, and I will be telling you the best and most popular costumes of this Halloween. This year, there were an enormous amount of solo cats, mummies, aliens, Kim Possibles, and many more. Most popular group costumes were angels, devils, space cowgirls, boxers, white claws, and of course, the Spice Girls. The most unique solo costume that I had to see was Guy Fieri, and the most unique group costume that I saw was 100% the group of Virginia Tech students who dressed up like the Virginia Tech apps, like Hokies on Track, Hokie Dining, Dual Mobile, and so on. I hope that everyone had a great weekend and a safe Halloween.
Fur has been the start of fashion and clothing, but over the decades, the debate over them hasn't been good. The business of fashion is trying to see if fur belongs in fashion or not. 50 million animals a year are slaughtered for fur coats, hats, and more. Animal rights activists believe that this is cruel and unethical to kill animals over fashion. Fashion Industries that uses fur says that it's natural and sustainable. Fur and fashion brings 117,000 enterprises, 1 million people work in the work industry, and $13 billion in profits. This brings the question in fashion, is animal lives worse the fashion profit and the looks that it serves? I'm Tasia Travis.
And I'm Ashley Brinkley. Up next, you'll finally hear about the new album from J. Cole.
Hello, I'm Michaela Shelton, and today I have music news for you. Rapper J. Cole announced at a performance last week that he will be releasing a new album next year. The new album will be called The Fall Off. J. Cole started working on the new album in April of 2018, right after his album K.O.D. was released. K.O.D. was J. Cole's fifth studio album and was nominated for Album of the Year at the 2018 BET Hip Hop Awards. On the pop side of things, the American Music Awards announced that Taylor Swift will be named Artist of the Decade. Taylor Swift has won a total of 23 AMAs. She has more than any other artist this decade, and just one short of Michael Jackson with the record of 24. Swift's latest album, Lover, could potentially help her break the overall record for the artist with the most AMAs. I'm Michaela Shelton, and that's all we have for you